power quality and list out various types of power quality issues in power system. Power quality can be defined as the goodness of the electrical power supply in terms of its voltage and current wave shapes, its voltage regulation, continuity of power supply and its frequency. Power quality concerns the electrical interaction between the network and its customers. It consists of two parts, voltage quality and current quality. Voltage quality supply voltage impacts equipment here. So in current quality what happens? It is reverse. Equipment current impacts the system. Okay. Here supply voltage will impact on equipment. Here equipment current will impact the equipment current impacts the system. Power quality, which involves both voltage and current quality, ensures correct and reliable operation of power system components. When distributed generation is considered, the situation becomes somewhat more complicated. So it makes sense to consider three different power quality aspects. So one is the voltage quality, current quality, and third is the tripping of the generator units due to the voltage disturbance. So this is the modern look at electric power system, network and customers. So these are the customers and electric power network. And it should be a two-way communication. Okay. So here first aspect is voltage quality. So here voltage quality, we have already came to know that voltage quality impact the equipment. So the voltage quality at the terminals of the generator is determined by other equipment connected to the grid and by events in the grid, that is faults in the grid. The impact of voltage disturbance includes a reduction of the lifetime. So because of this voltage disturbance, what happens? It is a reduction of the lifetime of the equipment and wrong tripping of the equipment. Wrong tripping of the equipment and damage to equipment. This issue should be addressed in the same way as for end user equipment. Important difference between generator units and other equipment connected to the grid is that the wrong tripping of generator units may pose a safety risk. The energy flow is interrupted potentially leading to machine oversteer and large over voltages with the electronic equipment. So the wrong tripping of the generator will lead the machine, leading to a machine overspeed and large over voltage with electronic equipment. So here, to give guidelines for the immunity of generator units against voltage disturbance, a distinction between variations, normal events and abnormal events is useful. This is the figure for the voltage quality. So here other customers, here distributed generation, here the voltage effect, and transmission and distribution network, here the fault. Okay. Here in current quality, from distributed generation to other customers, it is a reverse. So here from other customers to generator. So here from generator to other customers. Aspect of the power quality is a current quality. The generator current impacts the network and through the network other customers. The generator current impacts network and other customers. DG, that is distributed generation, used to improve voltage quality in a controlled way. This requires a means to control the current magnitude, the phase angle of a current compared to the voltage and the current waveform. Some of this is possible with a synchronous machine. So here what is DG is used to improve voltage quality in a controlled way. This requires what? This requires to means to control the current magnitude, the phase angle of the current compared to the voltage and the current waveform. So some of this is possible with a synchronous machine, but the main research activity concerns the control of the distributed generation with a power electronic interface. Okay, here the research activity is concerned the control of the distributed generation with a power electronic interface. Okay. So this is the third aspect of the power quality. Tripping of multiple generators could occur when the level of the voltage quality variations, for example the unbalance reaches exceptionally high values. It could also occur for voltage quality events such as the voltage dips. So when it will trip off the multiple generators, it will occur when the level of voltage quality variations. So it is like a voltage dips. The unbalance reaches exceptionally high values. It could also occur for voltage quality events such as voltage dips. So when it will trip means for voltage dips or voltage quality variations. It can thus expected that distributed generation will drift for extreme level of voltage quality variations and for severe events. As all generators connected to the same part of the network will experience a similar disturbance, the tripping of multiple units may occur. So many generators will be connected. Okay. So for if it is disturbance after that one generator, so it may cause, it may chances of having a multiple units may, tripping of multiple units may occur because of this disturbance at the single generator. Okay. So it can be expected that distributed generation will trip for extreme levels of voltage quality variations and for severe events, as all generators connected to the same part of the network, okay, will experience a similar disturbance. The tripping of multiple units may occur. So at disturbance distribution level, such as situation may be accepted occasionally, for example once a year or less at the distribution level. Okay. So mass tripping of DG, such a disturbance could spread over a large geographical area, resulting in the loss of large amount of generation. So there are many generation units will be connected, right? So mass tripping of DG, such a disturbance will spread over a large geographical area, that will cause a, or resulting in the loss of large amount of generation. So the resulting changes in power flow at transmission level, or even the lack of spinning reserve, that is margin generation, could cause a large scale blackout. So as such, blackouts are unacceptable. Okay, that will lead to, so multiple tripping of generator will lead to the blackouts. The transmission system operator have to look seriously into this issue. As a result, they set a strict requirements on the immunity of generation against the voltage and frequency variations, including voltage dips and short frequency swings. This is referred to as voltage fault right through. So the transmission system operator should take seriously about this issue, and they should improve the immunity of generation against these issues, that is voltage and frequency variations, including voltage dips and short frequency swings. So this is referred to as what? Fault right through. In network operator request the generator unit. The network operator requests the generator unit to disconnect from the network when a disturbance occurs in the distribution network. So there are two reasons for this. Instantaneous tripping of a DG during a fault will prevent any interference with protection of the distribution feeder. Tripping distribution units is to prevent uncontrolled islanding of power parts of the distribution system. So one is instantaneous tripping of a DG during a fault will prevent the interference with the production of the distribution breeders. Next is a tripping distribution units. Tripping distribution units is to prevent what? It is to prevent the uncontrolled islanding. Uncontrolled islanding of parts of the distribution system. So one is a instantaneous tripping of DG and second is a tripping distribution units. This is during a fault that will prevent the interference with the protection of the distribution feeder. And tripping distribution units is to prevent what? Uncontrolled islanding of a parts of the distribution system. So here, to prevent from dangerous situations or equipment damage, many DG are equipped with a sensitive protection that disconnects the unit upon detecting an unusual voltage magnitude or frequency, so called walk-off relay, that is rate of change of frequency.